For our next step in this process is Blur Xterminator or Deconvolution. Actually, it's Deconvolution, but I use a plugin called Blur Xterminator. Okay, it's a paid plugin. It's $99, but when you buy it, you're not going to regret it. I promise you. You don't want to go through the old way of doing deconvolution in Pixinsight. Let me just give you a preview of what that looks like right now. So here's deconvolution in Pixinsight. Oh my God, look at this. What the hell, man? I wouldn't even know where to start. When I first looked at this one, I was just like, oh my God. All right, now let's look at Blur Xterminator, which is the new way of doing deconvolution in Pixinsight. You know, maybe asking yourself, what the heck is deconvolution? It's a good question. It really is. It's a very, very good question. So deconvolution is the process of correcting anything that happened while you were out in the field. If you're in your backyard, you got, 10 hours of telescope photographing going on, you're going to get blur in your image. You're going to get blur in your stars and blur in everything else. That's why they call it Blur Xterminator. It kind of corrects that blur. I don't know how it does it. I don't know what kind of mathematical formulas are behind it, but it works. All right, let's take a little look at Blur Xterminator's interface compared to our crazy deconvolution interface that we just took a look at. It's as simple as selecting your AI. Of course, you're just going to want to go with the most recent one that's in here. So I have AI version 4 right now. You have settings for sharpening your stars, adjusting star halos. You got to fill in your PSF diameter, or you could choose an automatic PSF, which I don't recommend. But we'll get to that in a second. Sharpen non-stellar, which is your nebula right over here. Yay, non-stellar right here. And then there's a whole bunch of options over here. I don't really use any of these options. And, they do give you a nice little description here of why you should choose these options. So if you want to, you could explore that. But I never choose any of them. I'm going to just start off here. And I have to get a PSF diameter because that's one of the things with this. You have to get a PSF diameter. You don't want to use automatic PSF. It's just, it doesn't really work that well. Or at least in my experience, it doesn't work that well. To do get a PSF diameter, what you want to use is one of these Pixinsight built-in tools that has a very complicated name. You got to go to Script, Image Analysis, FWHM Eccentricity. All right, that's a pretty complicated name, isn't it? I know. All right, I'm going to click Measure on FWHM Eccentricity. And what I'm going to do is get out this medium FWHM. And you see this number is 2.773. We only take 3 digits in Blur Xterminator, so that's 2.77 to Blur Xterminator. Now, this is such a wonky thing, you gotta dismiss it before you could do anything else in the program. It's so weird, isn't it? It sounds, feels like the 90s called. Here we go. What I'm gonna do is just pull, now that I've punched in my PSF diameter, I'm just gonna apply it to the image. And that's all you gotta do. Is that amazing? This takes a long time. That's the only problem with it. So we'll be back. Okay, it looks like we are just about done. Up there we are. We're done. So what I'm going to do is zoom in here so you could see the effects of Blur Xterminator. Okay, so that is with Blur Xterminator right now. What we're going to do is go back, and that is without Blur Xterminator. So yeah, that's a pretty damn difference, huh? That's pretty big. Okay, so let's go forward again. Okay, so now we could see this is with Blur Xterminator. This is without Blur Xterminator. This is with. This is without. With. Without. All right, you could see, yeah, that's a pretty big difference. So $99. Yeah, go buy it. Go buy it. It's gonna work miracles for you. Just do it. You know, never regretted buying this. So go buy it. I'll see you on the next one. We're gonna be looking at multi-scale linear transform, which basically translates to noise reduction. So I'll see you there. Bye.